Welcome, everyone, to another episode of Sports Talk on the Success Table. I am Zach Barnett. Before we get into this interview, don't forget to subscribe and like this video. Also, if you like our content, hit the notification bell. Let's get into our interview today with Andre Carter, defensive lineman that played in the NFL. Like, after your NFL career was over, how did the LSU Tigers approach you to be their one of their D-line coaches?
What happened was I ended up, as I took some time off, went back to school, got my degree, and then from there did the internship with San Francisco 49ers. So that was kind of like my journey through coaching. But once when I was assistant defensive line coach for Miami Dolphins, Durante Jones was our defensive coordinator. He was our DB's coach at the time. We just always stayed in touch. And, you know, years later, you know, we parted ways. Obviously, that's the business, and went up with the Jets. And fortunately, the Jets kind of let go of the staff. Roger Jones hit me up and said, hey, man, would you like to coach at LSU? I was like, sure. Not like I had nothing else going on. So, to coach at a top five, big five school, I mean, that's a dream come true. I think that's something that any coach who has aspirations to coach on this level should aim for. And it just worked out. And it's funny, me and Coach Orgeron go back in the day, because actually he tried to recruit me when he was a D-line coach at USC. And so that is kind of funny how things evolve in full circle.
That guy is a hard worker for sure. And his voice.
Oh, yeah. He's Mr. Cajun. He's Mr. Cajun. He's got it. He's got it. Yeah, but people love it.
For sure, man. So getting on to a new topic, Chiefs or Tampa Bay, who do you think will repeat, go to the Super Bowl again?
I may be biased, but I'm going to – and the reason why is because I know Tom, so I'm always going to root for Tom when it comes to come to the Bucs. And then I was very fortunate when I was assistant D-line coach with the Dolphins. You know, Sue was there. One of my D-line players, Steve, nose tackle, he's still over there. He got himself a ring finally, you know, after, you know, 10 plus years in the league. So I'm just rooting for Tampa, you know, because I got some guys that play for that team.
For sure. Don't you see the final end, Bill Belichick versus Brady in the Super Bowl?
It could happen. It'll be interesting. Like I said, Bill is just a mastermind, and yeah, I'm sure he'll know how to get the Tom, and Tom know how to get the Bill. But that'll definitely be one for the books.
For sure. So among the top prospects coming into the league this year in the 2021 NFL draft, who do you think will have the immediate impact this year?
You know, it's so crazy because, you know, COVID kind of changed a lot. And so when it came to the players, from a defensive line standpoint, it was kind of hard to gauge kind of who was going to be elite and who wasn't. But just getting a feel for some of the guys that got drafted, the Jalen Phillips kid that got drafted to the Miami Dolphins, I knew and heard and seen a little bit. I knew he had some tangibles. I know he had kind of been hurt and nicked up, but he showed an upside. So it'll be interesting to see kind of how they roll him and or get him going as a starter or going to rotation as a situational pass rusher. He's got some good length. And then another guy that stands out was Azeez Ojulari. Now, it's kind of funny because I coach his brother, BJ Ojulari. And so, but I knew Azeez was a great pass rusher for the New York Giants. So those are two guys that really stood out to me. And it's funny with BJ, I was telling him, well, now you got to beat your brother. You know, your brother was the 50th pick in the draft. So anything better than you and then anything better, that's bragging rights.
I hear you, man. So what about the corners this year? There's several good ones out there that came.
Yeah, so, you know, obviously I know, let's see, I'm trying to think off the hat, off the tap. You know, obviously, let me see. I'm just kind of going on the top of my head here. Because I know, let's see. Sorry about that. You know, Virginia had that Caleb Farley kid. The Greg Newsom kid was pretty legit. Eric Stokes from Georgia, he was good. Tyson Campbell. I say it was a big cornerback class this year. I know they had the Kentucky kid, and then obviously the Asante Samuel. You know, because I think his dad played around the same time I played.
Sure, with the Patriots.
Yeah. So actually, no, Asante Samuel went with the Chargers, Los Angeles Chargers. So I'm sorry. Yeah, his dad went with the Patriots, but I didn't play with them. I didn't play with them when I was with the Patriots. But So his son going to Los Angeles, I think that'll be good for him. I mean, man, and especially too when you have Aaron Donald, you know, creating havoc in the backfield. Hopefully, he'll get some interceptions there. So it'll be a good cornerback class this year,
for sure. And the Horn that went to the Panthers, he's going to be pretty good too.
Yes, sir. Oh, yes. No doubt.
From South Carolina, the Gamecocks.
Yes. So it was a big cornerback class issue.
This concludes our episode today, folks. We greatly appreciate the support. And if you're not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to get all our up-to-date content. And if you like this video, hit the like button. We greatly appreciate it. We welcome you back next time.